The celestial sphere is an imaginary sphere surrounding the earth onto which are projected the objects of the night sky. There are several fixed points in the celestial sphere that are important. The zenith is the point directly over your head. The nadir is the point directly below your feet. The line drawn across the sky that represents the highest elevation of the sun or any other object as it traverses the sky is called the meridian. The sun rises through to its highest point and then starts setting as it passes the meridian. The other important points are to define two angles anywhere on the celestial sphere that give uniquely the position of any star or object. Altitude and azimuth are two angles that can do this. Altitude is the angle with reference to the horizon, and azimuth is the angle along the horizon. Baby, I get so scared inside and I don't really understand. Is it love that's on my mind, or is it fantasy? Astronomers use a different coordinate system based on right ascension and declination. Heaven is in the palm of my hand, and it's waiting here for you. The other important track on the sky is the ecliptic, the path traveled by the sun. This is also the region of sky within which you will see the motions of the moon and the planets.
Shelter me in your warm and dark and grave. I remember going to church as an adult, right, for the first time when I started going to church, and I would walk in, and the pastor was like, he said, I want you to pray with your neighbor. And I'm like, well, my neighbor don't go to this church. I don't know if you mean. You want me to call my neighbor on the phone? That's creepy. I ain't going to do that. Right, then they explained to me, right, your neighbor is a person sitting next to you. Listen, I'm brand new at this Christian stuff. I didn't even know you're supposed to pray out loud, let alone with this lady. I don't even know this lady. What am I supposed to pray about? Lord, help these bumps go down on this lady's face. I don't know what to pray about. I don't know what I'm supposed to pray about, right? She went first. She was praying all good, and she must have been John the Baptist's little sister or something. Praying. She was like, Dear Heavenly Father, you said in your word in the 6th chapter, the third verse of the book of Matthew, the 601st word on page 1248. Lord, you said, but seek, S is in search, E is in everywhere, E is in excellent, K is in kingdom. You are the Alpha, Nisi, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Rapha. I'm thinking, man, she even know his nicknames. Now it's my turn to pray, right? But I don't got the spiritual vocabulary to just, but I'm not gonna let her outpray me. So I'm like, okay, God, first of all, you are good people. You know, you are good, Lord. You are good. You are good to the last drop, Lord. Because, Lord, I just gotta obey my thirst, Lord. You know, because choosy moms choose Jesus. So, Lord, because. No, as the rocket's red glare, Lord, it gave proof to the night, Lord. I believe I can fly, amen.
As long as the moon shall rise, as long as the river flows, as long as the sun will shine, as long as the grass shall grow. The Senecas are an Indian tribe of the Iroquois nation. Down on the New York, Pennsylvania line, you'll find their reservation. After the U.S. Revolution, Corn Planter was a chief. He told the tribe these men they could trust. That was his true belief. He went down to Independence Hall, and there a treaty signed that promised peace with the USA and Indian rights combined. George Washington gave his signature. The government gave its hand. They said that now and forevermore that this was Indian land. As long as the moon shall rise, as long as the river flows, as long as the sun will shine.